What is Home Assistant container? What is needed and how to install one? How to properly update a Home Assistant container installation after new Home Assistant release? I'll try my best to address all these questions right now, starting with what is Home Assistant container? Simply said, this is a Home Assistant running in your own container environment like Docker. That means if you manage to install Home Assistant using Docker software or something similar, you have a Home Assistant container installation. This type of installation is one of the four official and supported ways to get Home Assistant. All four installation types have some pros and cons, and there is no right or wrong way here. I'll not talk about the other three possible and supported Home Assistant installation methods in this video. I'll just say that the Home Assistant container is the second most popular type of installation according to the analytics.homeassistant.io website. However, if you want to understand all of the pros and cons of the different Home Assistant installation types, I can suggest to register for my webinar that is exactly about this topic. After seeing my webinar, you will know about the strengths and weaknesses of all four ways. The webinar is completely free, and you can see the address somewhere on your screen, or you can find a direct link in the video description. As summary, Home Assistant container is simply a Home Assistant installed using Docker or other similar containerization software, and it is also one of the four official methods to get Home Assistant. Next big question is how to install Home Assistant container, and I'll try to answer this with a real-life demo. I'll use a Docker, which is a free and probably the most popular containerization software available at the moment. Docker can be installed on any major operating system. For Windows and macOS, the Docker installation is nothing special. You just have to download the installation package from the official Docker website and to install that package on your computer as usual. There are some minor differences if you are using Linux. It all depends on your Linux distribution, but I believe the best approach will be to type in Google something like how to install Docker on Ubuntu or CentOS or whatever your Linux distro is. Anyways, I'm using macOS and I'll show you how the Docker looks like after it is installed and it is up and running. I'll not show you the Docker installation itself because, as I said, there is nothing complicated there. Having Docker running is one of the prerequisites to start Home Assistant container using Docker. The other one is to have a folder where the Home Assistant configuration files will be stored. That means I just have to create one empty folder somewhere on my computer and to remember the full path to that folder. That is it. Nothing unusual here as well. But now I have to execute one big and scary command that will do everything for me. How cheeky is that? I'll open the Home Assistant documentation and particularly installation Home Assistant container section. You can get the exact link from the video description. And I'll scroll down a bit until I see this platform installation label and this big Docker command. This is everything that I need. Of course, there are some prerequisites. You have to have a newer than this version of Docker, and you have to have this libseccomp library newer than this version. If you install the later Docker, you'll be fine with all of these prerequisites. So again, back to the command. I can copy and paste these, but first I have to change a few things. For example, this path to your Home Assistant config folder, and I have to select my time zone. So I'll open one terminal. If you're using Windows, you can open the command prompt, and I'll create one empty folder here. Make dir ha config. This will be my empty folder, Home Assistant config. I can enter inside this folder and I can type pwd, which will show me the full path that I'm going to use in this command. Next thing that I have to figure out is my time zone. I'm located in Europe, Sofia, so I'll open this link which is actually a Wikipedia article, and I'll search for Sofia. Here it is, I just have to type Europe/Sofia. If you're located somewhere else, try to find your continent and city here, for example, America, Toronto, and so on, Europe, Dublin, and so on and so forth. So, I have all of the things that I need, but to your config folder I have, and I have my time zone. I'll copy this command right now, and I'll paste it right here. But instead of executing it, I'll change a few things. Path to your config folder, I have it above. I'll copy this section and I'll paste it right here, just like that. And I'll also change my time zone text with my real time zone, which was Europe/Sofia. And I think I'm ready. This command should work in most of the cases, but for macOS, I have to remove one line, this one, network host, and to replace it with ports. I have to map the default Home Assistant port. This is very easy. I have to type -p8123:8123. That's the whole command. You can get it from the video description, of course. And now I just have to hit enter, and that's it. Home Assistant container is up and running, and I can try to open the web address and the port 8123 to see the Home Assistant interface. Let's try this. The docker run command will download the latest stable Home Assistant image from internet, and it will start it. And I'll have to do the heavy lifting, which is to open the Home Assistant web interface. I'm kidding here, it is just the opposite. I'll check my current IP of my laptop. It is this one, 10.0.0.115. And I'll type exactly this, 8123 as a port. And this is it, brand new Home Assistant up and running. And it is the latest stable version installed using the Home Assistant container method. How cool is that? As you may know, there is one major Home Assistant release in the beginning of every month, and multiple minor releases during that period. The procedure that I just showed you was about how to install the latest stable Home Assistant container version. But next month, there will be newer latest stable version of Home Assistant, and you may want to upgrade. Here is how I can update my Home Assistant container installation properly. I'll use the same page of the Home Assistant documentation, but I'll switch to this update tab, and I'll again copy and paste the commands listed here, which is very, very hard, I must say. Of course, I'm kidding. The first one is to pull the latest stable image of Home Assistant. I'll copy the command and I'll paste it in my terminal /command prompt. Just like that. This command may take some time depending on your internet connection. In my case, because I'm already with the latest stable image, it finished instantly. Next step is to stop the existing Home Assistant container. This can be done using this docker stop and the name of your container. If you wish to double check your container name, you can either use the docker dashboard container section, here it is, Home Assistant is the name of my container, or I can use this docker container ls-a. This will list all of the containers that I have. This is the name, it is not well formatted because of the screen size of this window, but you'll figure it out. So as end result, my container name is Home Assistant, and I can use exactly the same command as here. But if your container name is different, you should change that. Docker stop, Home Assistant, and I'll wait for this to finish as well. It can take a while. The Docker Home Assistant container is now stopped. Next is to remove the actual container. I'll use this command, which is next from this update list. And if I execute the Docker container ls minus a command again, I will not see the Home Assistant container listed because it is stopped and removed already. And the final step is to create a new Docker Home Assistant container, and you can use this command. Something very important here, this command right here to update your Home Assistant container and the initial installation command are exactly the same. So the best approach here is to copy your initial Home Assistant installation command, this one, and to save it somewhere and to use it every time you update your Home Assistant. Again, this command is exactly the same as the installation command. So copy this, adapt it to your needs, change the My Time Zone with the one from this Wikipedia article, and change the path to your config with your Home Assistant config folder. And I'm going to do exactly that. I'll open again my terminal. I can scroll up a bit and I'll copy and paste the exact command that I used during the initial installation of Home Assistant container. So I'll copy this and I'll paste it right here. Again, you should change the time zone with your time zone, and you should change this config folder with your config folder where your Home Assistant configuration is. If you're using macOS, you should replace this network host switch with this port mapping 8123, which is the default Home Assistant port. I'll just hit enter and the Home Assistant container is started. I can double check that. I'll open a new tab and I'll enter my laptop IP :8123 as a port, and here it is. My Home Assistant is up and running and it is updated to the latest version. If some of the terms and abbreviations that I'm using are not so clear for you, don't worry, I'm here to help. I've put together a smart home glossary and I want to give it to you for free. You can download that from my website automatelike.pro/glossary. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!